Hello everyone, my name is Lauri Koutaniemi and I'm from Finland. Yeah, I just flew here on Sunday and had a couple of days in beautiful Gdańsk, so I really enjoyed my stay. Okay, a little bit about my background. So I'm a really technical guy. I'm a CTO usually in companies, so I'm the guy who is developing software and not usually meeting people or just staying in a basement and coding. But today it's nice to be here and share some of my ideas and get feedback and talk with you. So I'm a serial entrepreneur. I'm focused on education and also games and creative apps. I have been working 17 years and involved in about 10 companies now. And I've done a collaboration with Google, Adobe, Rovio, Intel, and Microsoft. And currently I'm living in Finland, but in the past 10 years I've been traveling around the world and also in Poland, in Szczecin, about 10 years ago when I had a game company. Yeah, like in the introduction, he said that my goal is to change education globally. So I really believe the education is the key. And that's why I've been focusing on education in the past 10 years. More information about and my contact information can be found from my website, koutaniemi.com. Okay, so I'm today talking about artificial intelligence and solutions that how we can use it in education and especially in learning platforms. There's really no way to put artificial intelligence in one sentence because it includes so many different things, like robotics, or there's so many different fields in like in algorithms, engines, and programs in AI. But I think Richard Knight in their book Artificial Intelligence in 91, they said it really well, that the study of how to make computers do things that currently people are better. You might think that, okay, it's quite wide thing to say, but because computers, for example, doesn't have legs and how they can run, but there's many robots that already run faster than humans. Artificial intelligence is divided in two different categories. So there's weak AI and there's strong AI. And currently, most of the applications, programs, engines are using weak AI. One really good example is Siri that you probably have in your smartphones. Let's see if it works so I can give an example. Hey Siri, what do I have tonight?
I couldn't say.
He couldn't say. I will. Maybe it's an echo here. What do I have tonight? It's thinking.
Interesting question, Lauri.
Okay. This is maybe an internet problem, but I tried it maybe like 10 times and said it correctly. So there's still a lot of problems, even with Siri. I will give Siri third time. Let's try it one more time. Hey, Siri. What do I have tonight? Thinking. Okay, I give up. Siri is not working today. Yeah, it's pretty clever system. You should try it. Maybe the echo that it cannot detect my speech, but Siri has developed a lot in the past years. If you compare the first versions to current version, Siri's task is to help to connect my speech to the apps that I have installed in my cell phone. So it finds my calendar events. It uses internet as a massive database to gather information and get information from there. So Siri is a really good example of weak AI. So what is strong AI? Maybe you have seen some AI movies where for example, Ex Machina, that there's a robot that thinks like a human, and that's strong AI. So strong AI's overall goal is to build intelligence compared to human mind, so it can work as well as human mind. So there's always some kind of consciousness or intelligence in it. Yeah, so like I showed you, Siri is trying to solve these things and running our lives, but it doesn't work all the time. But when I use it, it usually works. It's pretty good already. There's some other good examples like Uber, Airbnb, even Netflix. It's a really good example. So it uses AI to give movie recommendations. So what happens is that you watch movies, then it compares to people who watch the same movies that you watch, and then give recommendations that maybe you would like this and that. Okay, let's go to education. So how we can use this kind of artificial intelligence in education? I have been thinking this a lot. So my goal is to build platforms that utilizes artificial intelligence and helps people around the world to learn better, to be more fun and motivating for everyone. So I have found personally these five key things. So these five key things is my opinion how to use artificial intelligence in education. So the first one, really important, AI tutoring. I will tell more about all these five, so I will just go them through. The second one, intelligent virtual reality. Third, personalized learning. Fourth, adaptive group formation. And five, moderation and grading. Okay, first about AI tutoring. So there are already many these kind of AI tutors in use. There are a lot of tutors that are providing service, like there are human tutors, for example, helping online, but they use certain AI engines. There are also pure digitalized tutors. For example, Edwin is one good solution. If you go to edwin.ai, you can find a bot that it works in a Facebook Messenger and teaches you English just by chatting. So it's not a real human, it's just a bot. And bot means it's like a digitalized robot that just talks you in a Facebook Messenger, gives you tasks, learns what you respond, and then goes to this kind of personalized learning aspect, so it adapts to your cognitive level. And of course, really important thing is that it can give instant feedback. You don't need to wait till you go back to school. You have instant feedback from AI tutor. The second one is intelligent virtual reality. So you all know what's virtual reality, but how to make it intelligent is, for example, combining this kind of AI tutor with the virtual reality world. So let's think about that. In school, you are teaching for kids or any learner about Mars, planet Mars. It would be really expensive to get these people to Mars and walk on the surface of Mars. But with virtual reality, we can just take people with virtual headsets or just with the web browser on the surface of the Mars, and there you will meet our AI tutor, for example, robot, who says that, okay, welcome, and explain things in Mars. So AI is usually used to enhance to the virtual reality. The third one is personalized learning. For me, I think this is the most important thing if you think about like giving equal possibilities for everybody in the world to learn things. If you think about the math class, for example, that you are in school and you have a certain tasks for each student. There's a very different kind of level of knowledge of the specific task. So there is always people who knows exactly what to do and they get frustrated. There's always people that are struggling there's people who knows it and get bored. There's people who are struggling and get then frustrated. And there's people who knows when it's in the middle level, so it's like this kind of flow level that you are on the flow and you are learning. So personalized learning with AI means that the AI will understand your level of knowledge. It's thought like asking a couple of questions first. But if you think about a platform, for example, what I'm trying to develop, is that we have so much data about the learner. We know what kind of level of knowledge he or she has about math or writing or English or anything else. So we can personalize the tasks to every single one. And it's not just level of knowledge, it's also the resources. It's also about the cultural background. It's very different for you and me compared to people in India that doesn't have the same kind of devices and equipment that we have. Maybe some people even don't have a possibility to go to school every day. They need to work. So with personalized learning, the learning can happen anytime, anywhere, and for anyone. And I think this is like the one of the key solutions that we really need to do. The fourth one sounds quite like small thing, but I think this is also very important. It's adaptive group formation. And this means that when we have all this data about the learners, if we have, for example, in database, let's say 1 million kids, we have 1 million learners in our database, and we want to form groups from that. We have a lot of data, so we can find a similar interests, similar knowledge, and put it to the same group. Even with in a classroom, if we have a situation that, for example, 20 learners, they go to Mars, they have our AI tutor, Marsbot, giving them some tasks about Mars. And after this task, the AI can automatically form groups because there was tasks that the AI understood that these people are in the same level of knowledge of Mars and they would do this teamwork together. Or the other option is that if we need to, for example, do a project that needs somebody who is really good in art, doing like the cover and the graphic, somebody can compose the music, somebody can do the text, the AI can find these different expertise from the people and combine them as a one group. So I put these two as examples here. So usually these kind of artificial intelligence applications, programs, algorithms, engines, platforms are for individual learner, but it can help also for forming groups. And fifth one, this is quite obvious and already used in many applications, is moderation and grading. This can help both the learner and the teacher. If we think about teacher, it helps a lot and saves teachers' times and give more time for other tasks. So, for example, AI can correct the essay mistakes, for example. Of course, the teacher needs to read the essay and do the final grading, but AI can help a lot before that, like save 80%, 90% of the time, because it will do background checks. Is the image, are the texts taken from somewhere? Is there some references missing? Are the dots in the correct places? And so on. But what is more, more interesting is that AI can help the student before it goes to teacher and show these places that, hey, wait a minute, you are doing something wrong, or you should put this there and that there. And also give tips and hints that, hey, you're writing about this, have you seen this article, or have you think about this, if it goes to a little bit more advanced. So it can point places also for teachers how you can improve the course. In the best world possible, it would automatically improve the course. So it will see that, okay, nobody knew answer to this question. Let's remove it from there and put it to the next year's program. So AI can help a lot of teacher and student in moderation and grading. Okay, I have a little bit more time, so I have some grand challenges for artificial intelligence. The first one is what I meant building this kind of global platform, is to get virtual mentors for every learner. It's quite easy to do a simple AI or AI tutor for people who are using the latest phone models and smartphones. But to think about all world, every learner, cultural backgrounds, all the different devices, how we can do that. Then the second thing is addressing 21st century skills. If you think about skills like creativity, problem solving, critical thinking, these kind of 21st century skills, it's really difficult to use AI in that. And that's one of the grand challenges. For example, I have been developing these kind of creative apps for almost 15 years, and I created this Sumo Paint application that is like a Photoshop that works in a browser. And then kids had a possibility to create art and share it to others and comment and even create new friends. But how could we use artificial intelligence in that? I have been thinking a lot, like, how could we improve people to find the others there, or improve their creativity? Is creativity something that we can teach? Then analysis of interaction data. So there's a lot of data coming, how we can analyze, how we can learn how the person interacts, how we can get the knowledge level, and provide opportunities for global classrooms. So how we can get this kind of network of learners. If you think about the current school world, there are many students that are alone. They don't have friends. And if we build this kind of global network of schools, they can have friends, like in my Sumo Paint application, they can have friends from other countries with similar interests. And last, I just threw some random stuff here, are some figures, why we should focus on education and also technologies around it. Every $1 spent in early year education will bring up to $15 in economic growth. That's crazy. And why people should stay in school and really study is that each additional year brings individual earnings up to 10% in average. It's from World Bank last year. And then if we combine these two and we think about countries like, for example, India, this 1% growth in country's economy, poverty is cut by 0.6 to 4.3%. And this is the funny thought, but the students that are entering this year to school, they are graduating 2030. They are the workforce in 2040. So if you think about what the school is, like Sophie said in her presentation, it was really, really good, by the way. So she said that nobody knows how the world is in 20 years, and there might be this and this and this and needs. So I think artificial intelligence can help a lot can help a lot to get to this point that we can get everybody educated. Thank you.